It's an absolute pleasure to have you with us in London. Can you start by just telling us a little bit about how you feel about having this story, this part of your life and these beautiful women's lives captured on screen in this way?
Well, it feels always a little bit surreal to see someone else playing yourself on the screen. But yeah, it is. It was from the beginning something that felt like a film that you watched on in the cinema or on somewhere else on Netflix. So yeah, this is how it feels.
When people do get to experience that story, what are you most hoping they take away from that?
Well, a lot. I mean, there are a lot of things we can get out of it. First of all, it is a film. It is entertaining us, and we should enjoy it. That is the first thing. But of course, there are the stories. So after watching the film, we should take something out of it. We should think about the actors and also what they play and what they did and what the message is. And the message should be, first of all, that everywhere in the world are people who are facing very hard challenges. But they have the same rights, they have the same dreams, and they should have the same perspective or the same opportunity. Well, I mean, the Olympics, these five rings are for every athlete and coach something special. And what the IOC did with the decision to found this refugee Olympic team, this was changing for a lot of things. And I hope that the good things that started with this in the part of sports for development worldwide, not only for refugees, but also for developments in the world. I hope this will be continued and that people will see it and will support it.
Can you talk to us a little bit about what it means for you to have your story brought to life by these beautiful people on this platform, on this screen?
I honestly feel this is crazy, but just being here, it makes me so happy. And as you said, the story was made by incredible people, and it turns out to be amazing in the end. The movie is incredible, and I'm just happy to be here.
Can you talk a little bit about Xale specifically and what it was as a storyteller that gave you the confidence that she was the right person to share your story with the world?
Yeah, first of all, she was a female, so that gave me a lot of comfort. And in general, I checked out her work before. I talked to her a bit about the story and the script and everything. She was very understanding. She was open for criticism. So in general, she was a great fit. And she did a great job, to be honest. So, yeah.
And when people do get a chance to see the film, both here at the festival and all around the world, what are you most hoping overall they take away from that experience?
Yeah, I'm really, really hoping that they change the way they think about refugees, the perception of what a refugee is, that they understand that refugees are normal people. They're engineers, doctors, singers, athletes, and we do just want a normal life again. We come here because we do not want to live in a war or, our whole life. So that's why we escape. And that, I hope that people understand that we can help refugees, and there is enough space on this planet for everyone.
Has the process of being involved in making this film and watching it made you reflect on your own extraordinary journey? Do you have any particular thoughts or feelings that have really come to the surface while revisiting this portion of your life?
I mean, in general, it's everything is really, really emotional with the movie, as it is my story with my sister, and it makes me a bit emotional just to remember everything and to go through everything, but it also makes me proud. But yeah, I just miss my country, and it makes me miss it more. But in general, no, it makes me very proud when I watch it.